Hi, good morning to one and all. Already we discussed in previous lecture what is manufacturing, types of manufacturing. In this lecture we will learn about the what is casting, what are the different types of casting process, steps involved in casting, what are the different elements in casting. Okay, before going to casting process is one of the earliest metal shaping process technique known to human being. It means pouring molten metal into a refractory mold cavity and allows it to solidify. Next, the solidified object is taken out from the mold and by breaking or removing the mold. Next, the solidified object is known as the casting, and this process involved is known as the casting process. Next, it is the diagrammatic representation of casting process. It consists of molding, next molten metal. In this diagram, observed in first diagram, it consists of two parts, lower one and upper one. Lower one is known as drag box and upper one is known as cope box. These two are known as flask or drag or cope box. These to be placed on the molding board. First, you have to place the drag box and place the pattern and apply, fill the flask with the molding sand. By proper ramming, we have to prepare the molding. After that, we remove the pattern and will create the mold cavity. In this mold cavity, we have to pour the molten metal from the sprue. Okay, after some time it gets solidified. After that, we have to remove the casting object by breaking the mold material. Okay, next we will get the object is known as casting. This object is known as casting, and this process is known as casting process. It consists of sprue and runner. These to be trimmed or grinded. After that, we will get the required object. This process is known as the casting process. Next, coming to types of casting, there are different number of castings will be there, that is sand casting, shell mold casting, plaster, ceramic, vacuum, etc. These all casting process will be mainly divided into three categories. First one is expandable mold and permanent pattern. Second one is expandable mold and expandable pattern. Third one is permanent mold. What is the difference between these three categories? In first category, that is expandable mold and permanent pattern, is this. Here, suppose already we discussed, after the completion of solidification, we have to remove the solidified object from the molding by breaking the molding sand. By breaking means that is known as expandable. Here the permanent is pattern is permanent. The pattern is used to for next casting process. That process is known as expandable mold and permanent pattern. Coming to second one, in second one, expandable mold and expandable pattern. For this case, for every casting process, we need to prepare the molding material and pattern. In this case, the pattern will be expandable and the mold also expandable. Coming to third category, it is known as permanent mold. Here the mold is permanent. The mold is made by using the metallic parts. Here there is no, without pattern we have to prepare the casting by using the fixed mold or permanent mold. The mold is prepared by the metallic parts. We will get the mold cavity in metallic dies. We have to pour the molten metal into the shape. Into the dies, by opening the dies, we will get the casting object. Next, coming to elements in casting, there are different number of elements in casting. Mainly, it can already discussed in first slide. It consists of mainly two flasks, that is drag box and cope box. In these, we have to place the pattern. After that, after making the mold, we have to remove the pattern. In some cases, we use core material for making the hollow objects. Here the sprue, the pouring basin. Here the pouring basin. It is the topmost object of the molding flask. It is used to pour the molten metal by using the pouring basin. From pouring basin, molten metal will pass from here to mold cavity by using the gating system. The gating system consists of number of elements, that is sprue, choke, runner, gate. All these elements consist of under the gating system. The molten metal from top to mold cavity, it will reach to the mold cavity. After the filling of mold cavity, the excessive molten metal will come from the riser. It is used to indicate the complete filling of the raw material. After that, here the vent hole is used to suppose any air entrapment in the mold cavity, the air bubbles will escape from the to the vent hole. Next, these are the front view and top view of the molding board. If top view will absorb clearly, it is the pouring basin, it is the runner, it is the gate. Whenever we pour the molten metal from here to the molten metal will reach to from runner to gate to the mold cavity. Here the core is used for making the hollow object. Next, it is the molding sand. Next, core. It is the front view of the molding flask, drag box, coke box, potting surface, riser, gate sprue, pin, gate. You have different elements in the casting process. Next, steps involved in casting. The casting process mainly consists of three parts, that is pattern making, mold making and pouring section. The first, we have to create the pattern based on the shape of the object. The pattern material consists mainly wood, metal or plastic. Based on the requirements, we have to select the material of the pattern. Pattern is nothing but a replica of the object, that is duplicate of the object. Based on the dimensions of the required object, we have to prepare the pattern. Next, here by sand and preparation of sand, by using the sand we have to prepare the molding. Next, here core is needed for making the hollow object. Next, raw material is converted into molten state by using the melting process. After that we have to pour the molten metal into the mold. After that, solidification and cooling. After the pouring of molten metal into the mold, we will wait some time based on the type of the liquid. Molten metal will get the solidified object and removal of sand from the molding board. Next, after finished casting, that is we have to remove the dust particles from the casting object by using the cleaning. Next, cleaning and inspection. After inspection is by checking the dimensions of the object. Based on the drawings, we have to check the dimensions or any defective products are there. By using the inspection, we have to filter the objects. Next, first one is pattern making. Make the pattern of wood, metal or plastic. Next, sand mixing and preparation. Select particular sand, test it and prepare the necessary and mixing for mold and coring. Before the making of molding, we have to test the sand for the it will withstand for the forces developed due to the molten metal. Next, core making with the help of pattern, prepare the mold and required core. Suppose we have to manufacture the hollow object, we have to prepare the core. Next, melting. Melt the metal or alloy to be cast. Next, pour the molten metal or alloy into the mold and remove the casting from the mold after solidification of metal is known as pouring. Next, finishing. Clean and finish the casting object from removing from the molding sand. For removing the dust or any dust particles sticking to the casting object. Next, testing. Test and inspect the casting and remove the defects if any. Suppose in some cases blow holes or pin holes or some defects defective will be occurred during the casting process. These will be filtered by using the testing or inspection. Next, heat treatment. Relieve the casting stresses by using various heat treatment. Heat treatment given to the for corrosion resistance, wear resistance and heat resistance. By using the heat treatment process, we will get will do. Next, retesting. Again, inspect the casting and deliver to the tool. For strength and stresses, we have to restress the object. Next, these are the workflow diagram of casting for casting process. Observe. It is the first one. We have to prepare the mold making by using the machine molding or hand molding. Next, it is the process of converting the raw material into the molten metal by the different process, that is induction, electric arc and cupola. These three are different melting process is used to convert the raw material into the molten metal form. Next, here core preparation by using the core sand and binder. These are the different machines is used to prepare the core. After preparation of core, from these two we will prepare the molding. These portions is known as the molding. Next, the molten metal coming out from the melting units, it will poured on the in the molding moldings by using the ladles. After that, these moldings will pass through the pass out from the section. After some time, it gets solidified by shake out the casting. We will remove the solidified object, and then these sand will be returned to the sand preparation unit. After that, we will get the casting object. It is known as casting object. After that, we will cooling and cleaning by removing the dust from the casting object. After that, it will pass to the finishing. Suppose any excess material by using grinding machine or machining, will remove any excess material. After that, will ship into the inspection unit. It is the overall workflow in typical sand casting process. Next, it is the stepwise preparing of mold. First, we have to place the molding board. After that, we have to place the drag box. Next, place the two-piece pattern. First, we have to place the off piece. After that, we have to fill these box with the molding sand. After that, we have to rotate the dry box into 180 degrees from this diagram to this diagram. We will observe we are rotate the drag box in 180 degrees by we will get like this. After that, we have to place the core box above the drag box by placing the remaining off piece of pattern. After that, we have to place the sprue pin and riser pin. The riser pin is placed above the object or beside the object. After that, next, this drag core box will fill by the molding sand. By proper ramming, we'll get the mold cavity. After that, we have to remove the pattern from the
molding, we'll get the empty portion. This empty portion is known as mold cavity. Here, from pouring basin, we have to fill the molten metal from here to the molten metal reach from here to here. Whenever the mold cavity will be filled, the excessive molten metal will pass from here to here. That is, it will pass into the riser hole. It is used to indicate the material will be filled. Next, after some time, the material will be get solidified. By removing the molding sand or mold, we will get the solidified object. That object is known as casting, and this process is known as casting process. Okay, thank you.